name is Stephanie Marquez, and I'm the principal of Dixon High School, and I just want you to know that I have the best job in the world. Beyond stellar students here and kids of good character, we get to work every day with teens. And they're powerful, and they're wonderful, and they're growing, and everything else. And every once in a while, we get them all going the same direction to do something. And we're going to give you a taste of that tonight. So tonight, you're going to hear from our band. You're going to see my favorite performance, which is our indoor field show. It's our halftime show at homecoming done in here. It's loud, and it's raucous, and it's pretty. And you'll hear from our choir, and you'll hear from our dance team, and you'll see what our drama kids put on, and then we'll share some dessert later. Oh, you'll also hear from Catelyn O'Halloran, who's going to present our lovely families that started this whole thing with kids. So thank you all for coming. And with that, I turn it over to our band.
Thank you. Drop the freezer.
I am Pat O'Halloran. I'm on the Dixon School Board. I'm also a product of the Dixon School System. And when I was in high school, I was in the performing arts. Tonight, I have the pleasure of telling you a little about how our honorees are going to be honored tonight and sharing the process of how we will memorialize this dedication of the building. Many of you in the audience have had the pleasure of performing under the direction of one of these men. Or, if you're like me, you've had the honor of performing under the direction of two of them. I know that most of you in the audience can also attest to the transformative power of the arts. Whether it's music, theater, or dance, one of the best parts of the performing arts is the ability for a role or a song to take you somewhere that you never imagined. And for me, that happened when I was in high school, and Richard Farshler chose Gypsy as our spring musical. In what will come as a shock to no one, I was a skinny, gangly teenager. So, obviously, Farshler cast me as a raunchy, trumpet-playing, gold lamé-wearing, vaudeville stripper. So there I was on the stage of the old Dixon High School cafeteria, which is where we all performed before there was this beautiful building. And I was wearing about 2 inches of gold lamé, doing my best to channel my inner stripper and belting out my character's song, which had the signature line, "If you're gonna bump it with a trumpet." Thank you, Farshler, for that transformative moment. Now, all of you have a program, and it has a paragraph written by family and friends of the honorees. I know that you're all strong readers, especially if you went to Dixon High School, so I will not read that to you tonight. But I am going to read some additional information that's on the plaques that will hang after tonight in this building. We decided to do two things. First, we decided to dedicate this building, as was voted on in our board meeting, on February 5th, 2015. And second, tonight we will begin a tradition of honoring those who've had significant influence on the arts in Dixon. So first, let me read to you from the big plaque, just this one. These will also be in the dessert reception. You don't have to try to read it from where you are. And this says, "The Dixon Community Performing Arts Center is dedicated to William Hodge, Ross Hanna, Richard Farshler, with deep gratitude from the generations of students and community members who are richer for their contributions. Additionally, this plaque serves to memorialize all the Dixon leaders, teachers, mentors, and champions whose passion for the performing arts changed lives, embraced beauty, and opened hearts." And as you can see, they are our first three honorees. So in addition to having the building dedicated to them, they're also beginning our new tradition. And in that new tradition, we also have small plaques for each of them that will hang on the wall that talk about their years of service, and we've asked for three words that describe them. So I'm going to read those to you now as well. Ross Hannah, thoughtful, generous, man of character. Years of service, 1949 to 2014. Richard Bartler, nurturing, compassionate, creative. Years of service, 1969 to 2002. William Hodge, dedicated, honorable, supportive. Years of service, 1943 to 1976.
Okay. All right, so I think we start the feedback. Anshul, turn those 7 and 8 down a little bit. Thank you, Anshul, from the band for doing sound for us. So I'm Adrian Coulson. Many of you might know me as being, I've been the band director here for 26 years. And you might not have known that I, for the first 8 years of that, I taught choir here at Dixon High School. And then that got handed off in 2003 to somebody else, and they taught for a while, but then budgetary issues resulted in the elimination of choir here for quite a while at Dixon High School. So just starting this last year, partly because it's something that's been brewing for a while, but also because of the restructure with the sixth grade moving to C.A. Jacobs, the opportunity came up for me to start the choir. So. I'm quite happy with the way it's going. These nice young men and women on stage are the brand new Dixon High School Choir. I just put ads or, you know, like things in the announcements saying who wants to join choir, and not knowing at all what I was going to end up with to start the year or what kind of music even to purchase. It's worked out pretty well so far. This is our second performance. They sang the Star Spangled Banner at homecoming. And so we're gonna sing a song called A Million Dreams. By the way, the song that the marching band did, that was also from that Hugh Jackman movie, The Greatest Showman. So Stephanie alluded to that is a kind of a preview of our indoor field show thing. That's on November 9th. So if you come back, it's a pretty short program, 7 o'clock, and we do that. So song plus a few more, and we try to make it a little bit more theatrical. Sometimes we have kids sing things, and lighting and special effects. So December 9th for the band to see a full performance, and then the choir's first concert is going to be in 2 weeks on November 15th, Thursday night. So maybe come back and hear us. We'll probably sing this song again, plus several others, and some of our fine singers are going to sing some solos, I think. So wish us luck with the Bluetooth. It's a million years.
Thank you.
flowers, people. Come back. These fine young people who've been in choir for 11 weeks. Played the singularly best prank on Mr. Bogalski ever this year. If you want to see me about it, it deserved it all for you. So next we're going to see a drama performance from two of our drama kids in Romeo and Juliet recently. They're going to do a scene for you. I'm working on my drama language. I'd like to have you give a round of applause for Emily Mitchum. She is... school and, you know, has a small baby and a family as well. So she's a trooper. So here comes Emily and her group.
I don't know where my actors are. So. Oh, look at them, they're all ready. I didn't even need to tell them what to do.
Can I go forward? When my love is here, turn back to all earth and find thy center. And soft, where light through yonder the window breaks, is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Rise, fair sun, and kill thee in this moon. May it a funnel fed and cheap. A lesser degree is but secondary, and the fools who wear it. It off. Oh, it is my baby. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, but she says nothing. For I discourses, I will answer it. No, it is not to me she speaks. Two of the fair stars in all the heaven. If the brightness of her cheek would shame those stars. Oh, that I wear a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Hi, me.
She speaks. I'll speak again, bright angel, for thou art as glorious as the moon, as he strides the lazy pacing clouds and sails across the bosom of the air.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father, refuse thy name. Or if thou wilt not, be but sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more of this, or speak at it?
Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's Montague? 'Tis nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part of a man. Oh, be some other name! But which could call a rose by any other name but still smell as sweet? So Romeo would, or he not Romeo call, retain that dear confession that he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for thy name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word. Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth I never will be Romeo.
What manner art thou must be screamed in night so stumbles upon my counsel?
By a name, I not know how to tell thee who I am, but by a name, I am an enemy to thee. Had I it written, I would tear the word.
My ears have not yet drunk 100 words of that tongue's utterance, and yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if I would thee dislike.
How camest thou hither? Your true walls are high, hard to climb. It is death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
By the love did I overperch these walls. Stony limits cannot hold love out. Therefore, thy kinsmen are no let to me.
If they do see thee, they will murder thee.
Alack, there lies more peril in thine eye than 20 of their swords.
By whose direction foundst thou at this place?
By love. He did let me counsel when I led to mine. I am no pilot, but yet thou art as far, as vast as the far of the shore and sea. I heard adventure for such merchandise.
Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face. Also to make me blush be paint my cheek, for that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Fain would I dwell on form. Fain deny what I have spoke. But farewell, compliment. Dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say aye, and I will take thee at thy word. Yet if thou swearest, thou mayest prove false. At lovers' perjuries, then say, Jove laughs. O gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully. Or if thou thinkest I am too quickly won, I'll frown and be perverse and say thee nay. So thou wilt rule, but else not for the world. In truth, fair Montague, I am too fond, and thou mayst think my behavior light. But trust, gentlemen, I'll prove more true than those who have more cunning to be strange. I should have been more strange, I must confess. But that thou overheardest error was where my true love's passion. Therefore, pardon me, and not impute this yielding to light love which the dark night hath so discovered.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear that
the... swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon that monthly changes in her circled orbs, lest thy love prove likewise variable.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear at all. Or if thou wilt, swear by thy gracious self, which is the god of my idolatry, and I'll believe thee.
If my heart's dear love...
do not swear at all. Although I join thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too sudden, too unadvised, too like the lightning which doth cease to be, ere one can say it lightens. Sweet good night.
Oh, wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of my faithful vow for yours.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it, and yet I would it were to give again.
Wouldst thou withdraw it? For what purpose, love?
But to be frank, and give it thee again. I want but for the thing I have. My bounty is as boundless as the sea, and my love is deep. The more I give to thee, the more I have, for both are infinite. Good night.
Oh, blessed, blessed night. It is a fear that it may be all a dream to be so sweet and substantial.
Romeo! For a falconer's voice will lure this tassel gentle back again. Bondage his horse and may not tear the cave where echo lies. Else would I make her airy tongue more hoarse than mine with repetition of Romeo's name.
It is my lady that calls upon my soul, like soft music to attend ears.
Romeo!
My dear!
At what time tomorrow shall I send?
At the hour of nine.
I will not fail. 'Tis 20 years till then. I have forgot why I did call thee back.
Let me stand here to thou remember it.
I would forget again to have thee still stand there, remembering how I love thy company.
And I'll have thee still forget, forgetting why they came, forgetting any other home but this.
It is almost morning. I would have thee gone. And yet no further than a wanton's bird, who lets it hop a little from her hand, like a poor prisoner in his twisted gyves, and then with a silk thread plucks it back again, so loving, jealous of his liberty.
I would I were thy bird.
Sweet, so would I, and yet I would kill thee with much charity. Good night, good night. Pardon me such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night to it tomorrow.
1,000 times good night. I must go to my ghostly father's cell, his happy grave and my happy cell.
And there we go. And our last performance tonight before we thank our guests again and go spend some time together is our dance team. These folks have been performing for how many years? Maybe, well, not these individual people, other people, for about 6 years, I think, we've had a dance team at Dixon High School. And they are just champions. They are directed by Morgan Hicks, I almost said their duty, who's in the back there. So here we go. Thank you. All right. Thank you so much for enjoying our kids. We love these guys. And I want to tell you, to the Armies here, thank you so much for starting and continuing the arts in this wonderful community. It's a pleasure to be here every day. We have reception time. So if you want, please head out the theater doors and over to the cafeteria entrance near the large gym. We have some tables. Our jazz band will be performing, and we have dessert, coffee, and water, and pretty much anything if you need. We can all visit and get to know you better. So, thank you for coming out these doors. Some people wish that would happen every day. So, please head out these doors and down to the large gym entrance, and we'll meet you there for some community time. Thank you all, kids. You did yourself.